Welcome back to Don's Life. Welcome to the channel. Thanks for joining today. In today's episode, we are going to remove the rear valence and we are going to continue this camouflage wrap. Look how nice that looks. Right onto the valence here, but since we're going to have this off, we're going to pull the third brake light. We are going to tint it dark smoke. I had a light tint smoke on it before that we didn't cut out for the cargo lights, but this time we're going to put dark on that red ugly part there so it doesn't match anything. And we are going to cut out for the cargo light so we get full brightness. So hopefully you like these things, smash that like button, but let's get at it. Let's go. We are dealing with the potential of airbags going off, so disconnect the negative terminal on your battery. We have to remove these hangers. Easy to do. If you bend this in a bit, it creates a bigger gap right here. There's a seam. Use a pry tool to pry it open. Once you get the tool in there, it should pop back. Okay, we need to take off the C-pillars, but to do that, we need to pull back the weather stripping. That's usually pretty easy. Just like that, go as far as you want, but really we just need to expose this piece. And then that's just held in there with clips. So we'll pull that out. I got extra wire in there from my rear view camera, so that's what that is. And we'll do that also to the other side. Now we just need to undo that bad boy there. Pretty easy, 7mm. We'll remove the headrests. All right, time to pull the headliner down. So there's just push clips in behind here. Yeah, the window, this style with the sliding glass makes it a little harder to get in behind. Okay, we got it. You can usually get your fingers behind these big clips. I'll show them to you in a second here. But once you pull on those, it's not too bad. I just released the clips on this light too, just so we don't end up with a bend as we pull the headliner down. Just a good precaution. So if you just pull on this firm, but not too hard, you'll feel the clips release. And that'll give you a little more room to work with. So there's what those big clips look like. So once you get your fingers wrapped around the headliner, you can definitely grab onto those and yank them straight out. And the other ones are right there. So now I gotta get to the bolts that are up underneath here. And I'll have to do it by feel because it won't be that easy to see them. So I'll give you a better angle here. Okay, so holding the valence in, our bolts there, there, and all along evenly spaced. And then there's some plastic tabs, I believe they're yellow. You just can't see them yet, that we'll have to compress to pull out at the end. So I'm gonna use my ratcheting skills and sense of feel and try and back all these off. And good idea to have a magnetic socket because you don't want those bolts or nuts, sorry, falling down and going down your C-pillar here and potentially being lost forever. So, wish me luck. Okay, we've got all of the bolts off. You can see you can reach in here with a 10 millimeter socket and back them off. I just used one like this. Where you wanna make sure it's magnetic is for the bolts that are up in the corner around there. Not sure you can see it too well, but it'd be easy for them to fall down and get lost in the C-pillar. So that's where you wanna use those. Now the yellow pins that need to be pinched are just above the last bolt in the corners here. Sorry, I know you probably can't see that. So there's a yellow pin up here. You do need to disconnect your wiring harnesses here. So that's for the camera, that's for all the lighting. And then you can just unhook it here from the body and have these plugs free so we can fish them out when we pull the valence off. One more on the harness up here in the corner. I almost didn't see it. Okay, everything is disconnected except one of those yellow clips on this side. Really easy to do. I use these angled pliers. Give it a squeeze. Just pulled up gently as I did that. And it came right off on the other end. There we go. I just gently squeezed. Whoop, it's gonna fall. There we go. Yellow clip, bolt, bolt, two bolts, two bolts. As you can see, it just continues along. Then our grommet with all of our wiring. Now we just need to take out the third brake light. Okay, let's take out this third brake light. I see a bunch of hex screws or torque screws right there. Then we have some clips to undo. And we just have to work in this area. The wiring harness is just held in with these push pins, so we'll work them out. There we go, we'll clean that up and wrap it. And then we'll clean this up and we will wrap it. All right, we got the valence all cleaned up. You saw me do that on time lapse. Here she is, nice and clean. Got some camo vinyl ready to go, available from Vivid. I put links in pretty much everything I use in my video descriptions. So over to the time lapse. All right guys, we got the valence wrapped. Had a couple issues in the beginning. That table just wasn't working for me. Had to grab the bumper stand here. But as you can see, we have a nice wrapped camo valence. Now we need to smoke tint that, cut out for the cargo lighting area, reinstall, and then see what it looks like. Let's go. We'll be right back. All right, everyone, we got the third brake light all tinted up. So there she is. Cutouts for the cameras, looking good. Got all our edges wrapped around, but I'm gonna reinstall it on here first. And then that way I've got a bigger area to work with so I can have a firmer, basically platform to line up some cuts and cut out that light that you can't really see anymore in behind. So let's put it together and get to that next step. Okay, we've got it taped out. I just used the flashlight and kind of found where the edges were before it turned red and tried to look at kind of a straight on angle. So I think I got it. I'm gonna have to just know in all the corners that it needs to be rounded to make the gaps meet. They're not nice and straight like this. So this needs to be rounded. So I'll just slowly drag my blade along the edge of the tape at about a 30 degree angle. So just about like this, nice and light. And that should score the film. And then we'll peel it off really slow and see what we end up with. All right, guys, we're done the cutout. It is right here, behold. The cuts are pretty good, but the plastic has multiple layers to it, so the red and the clear touch each other. So at some angles, you're gonna see a little bit of red. Like you can see a hint when I get an angle there, but when I go over here, it disappears. So if you're straight on, it looks pretty good. So I'm going to put it all back together. I'll save you the time of watching me do that. But it's getting dark outside, so we'll put it together tonight. I'll pull it out tomorrow, and I'll show you what it looks like. Stay tuned. Right, there you go, the valence is all wrapped. Here's some footage of the cargo light and the brake light in the dark and in the light, so you can see that they still work pretty good. But I think I waited a little too long to do this project, but now it's done. But sometimes you just don't have time. Would have been nice to have completed it probably closer to when I did the roof, but you know, what can I say? Anyway, if you like today's video, please hit that like button, it helps a ton. If you're not a subscriber, do it, it's free, it's easy, just do it. Why not? Don't question it, just do it. Anyway, we'll talk to you guys later. See you on the next one.